I jumped up this morning with the sun down shining in. Found my broken mind in a brown paper bag within. I tripped on a cloud, I fell 8 miles high. I tore my mind on a jagged sky. I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. Pushed my soul in a deep dark hole and followed it in. When I met myself crawling out as I was crawling in. Got up so tight I couldn't unwind. Saw so much it broke my mind. I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. Somebody painted April Fool in a big black letters on a dead end sign.
Well, it won't go. Yeah, I'm out with my new big handbag. I'm up Buckham's Wall, Spurn, right at the top of the up at Coquetdale. I've had an early shift at work today. What day is it? It's Wednesday, the 23rd, 24th of June, in this year of a marvellous 2020. We're heading that way. Right up there. There's my finger. I don't know. I'm using a mobile phone again. So we're heading that way, past the wild mountain goats. Absolutely lush. I'll see you up there a little bit. Look, there's a tent. Whose could that be? What type of naughty individual would come out camping during lockdown? Ah, yeah, it's the lady that used to have an orange van. Yeah, it's a lady with a lingo. Little D at your service, and I am up Rennies. Been up Rennies before, about 2 years ago. It was just after the Beast in the East. Was that just 2 years? I can't remember. So, that was the one where I think I counted 28 or 29 dead sheep. I haven't passed a dead sheep so far this trip. Be lush. As I say, I've been on an early shift at work. Finished work at 3. Bombed home, packed my new big handbag. I've got an Osprey. I'll show you it later. Exos 48. Damn me. It's like carrying it hugs you. It contours to you. It loves you. It's like carrying a long lost child on your back instead of a kidnapped one. I didn't know carrying a rucksack could be that effortless. It's an absolute belter. I got it for a good price, so I'm happy, Donna. So I'm out, obviously, just testing the new rucksack. This tent's come along with this because obviously I've got to pack the rucksack correctly. So I had to put a tent in. Not much more I had in. Obviously, I'll not be staying overnight because, well, I haven't got provisions for to see a girl through an overnight in the wilds. So I'm advancing your crags tonight up the Rennies. I'm not going to get too much of a sunset, I don't think. I'm not bothered. I'm out. I'm going to stay out tomorrow as well, because I can. I see, I've had a long shift at work, it's been hot. You all know I work at a hospice. We've got to wear the masks now as well. Wearing a mask in a kitchen, it's really hard work. Nurses, I mean, yes, me whinging. Nurses have got to wear for 12-hour shifts. At least we don't do 12-hour shifts just yet. I'll shut up now, waffling, will I? I've got a new selfie stick. Oh, look how far away I can get from myself. Looks like somebody else is doing the footage. Little D reporting from Van Senior Crags, Rennies Burn. In a bit, darlings. Oh, that'll do, won't it? Eh? I could have went up higher, but you know what? This idyllic idea, yeah? You know what I'm like with my idyllic ideas? I had this idyllic idea of chilling my beers in the stream. So I don't know if you can see. There's my beers chilling in a Nasdaq bag in the stream. Living the dream, chilling beers in the stream.
8 miles out of Memphis and I got no fare. 8 miles straight up, downtown somewhere. I I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in.
I've got that much skin so soft on, but to keep the midges up here, it's like I've got stage 4 cataracts. I was having a lovely time out. Oh look, there's my tent down there somewhere. There's my tent down there. Lush. Everything's lush, isn't it? Apart from my vision's not lush. Oh, that's better. I'll tell you what, it'd be nice for to put a tent up here. Oh, look at that, huh? What a view. Apart from that, that's a recently deceased sheep. It looks quite healthy, apart from the fact that it's not breathing and it's lying down. Dead sheep number one, up the Rennies burn. Rennies burn never fails to impress with a dead sheep count. Ah, man, look. Aye. How nice is that? Midges are out. That's what I can hardly see. I've got no glasses on to start with for the sweat. Now I can hardly see for the skin so soft. I'm just keeping them at bay. Oh, you little sod, get off. It's keeping them at bay. Where am I? Oh, poor sheep. Well, look, I know you do. Poor sheep. See what I mean? Looks quite fresh. Maybe he's seen his little legs. Maybe it was hit by lightning. His little legs is like, I mean, my legs go like that when I get really bad cramp. Unless it's got really bad cramp and then it's just past rotten by bad cramp. Tell you what, that's a good looking little tent, isn't it? That's my little hidden valley. Vanstinia's. That's it, eh? Where's the little dollar there? Oh, Vanstinia's lost valley. Oh, there we go. There you go. Northumbrian midges. Now, each one of those bad boys is capable of delivering a hefty bite. And the love, the soft, sweet, flabby arms of city folk. Unless you're fully bombed up with skin so soft. No, I'll be honest, I haven't got enough skin so soft. I don't think Avon's got enough skin so soft for me. Damn me, look at them. Just waiting to get in. Yeah. Hiya, I'm in my little tent. Well, you know that. Otherwise I would have been outside screaming with a midget bait. I'm going to put my head down soon. It's bright light. It is, yeah, but it's like 9:15 at night. I've got to head over to Holystone tomorrow. I'm meeting up with a pal there for another naughty night out. Morning. Morning, there's a couple to pick from if whatever one you fancy. It's quite early for me, it's 9:30. Sat here having a lovely cup of coffee listening to the sheep. Listen to the sheep kick off. I'll get lost up the hill. Or maybe they're playing hide and seek, I'm unsure. So I not much filming last night, a lot of midges out. An inordinate a lot of midges out. I had to retire to the tent to hide from the midges, I believe. I did a bit of footage back in the tent. A decent sleep, all right. Got really dewy when it got dark, so that must have been midnight-ish, because it's only dark for 4 hours. Really dewy, so I had to flip the fly sheet back out of the tent. nice and comfy. I just brought out that little down type quilt that weighs nought and it packs down to like the size of a toasty. And I'll be honest, I was warm enough with that. So yeah, not much filming done yesterday. We went up, obviously we did the touristy things, we went up the hill there, seen the dead sheep, and that's really about it for the touristy things around here. But I don't do it for the touristy things, I do it for sit and listen to that. Sit and listen to the babbling brook that beautifully chilled my beers last night. Oh, there's my new. There's me, my new handbag. That's my Osprey Exos 48, which I got for a ridiculously cheap price with an online voucher. Champion. So very happy with my new addition to the family. I'm going to get off course. I just want to sit here, finish my coffee, finish my packing. As you can see, there's nothing left. A gentle, flattened piece of grass. That's all you'll know that I was here. No piles of rubbish, no barbecue burns on the grass. Anyone that does know, don't do it. And then you're giving us wild campers such a bad name. You'll never get that off a proper wild camper. That's just your day trippers from the city and stuff. Day trippers, they're not bad. These are your untrained day trippers. All you trained day trippers. You guys are blinking lush. Huh? Right, I'll catch you down there a bit. I'm with a Holystone today. Which is that way. Oh. Yeah, me lasses, you're noisy.
Just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. 8 miles out of Memphis and I got lost about 8 miles straight up downtown somewhere. I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. Oh, I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in.
I thought the way back up, like, I don't normally do quiet panoramic shots. Oh, well, that was the first time. This is where we'll join up with Buckham's Walls Burn. You see the joining of the burns. Slow down, Dee. Midgey crags, eh? Midgey crags. Right. These are the dangerous paths we have to traverse. Oh, what happens? I'm chucking the camera, like, on the phone. Distance. That's Lamb Hill Refuge Hut up there. One day. Please hold on. Bit sketchy. Just because I'm by myself and if I fell, that can't be very good, is it? Won't get a holy stone. I fell. Yeah, we're going to join into the burns and then I'll sign off for this part. Yes. Buckham's Wall. I've camped up there before a couple of times. And that's your Rennies Burn. I've camped down there now a couple of times. This is the way back there. Buckham's Wall car park, and I'll see you down the road. Ciao for now.
Gardens of Babylon.
Yep, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. As you can hear by the voice, I'm out with the law, my lady. If you'll just turn round, law, my lady. There she is. See, she does exist. Satsuma to you two. Right, so we're in then the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, Northumberland style. That's a bit like a giant Easter Island head, isn't it? We're like that. There's a little cave down the bottom. Yeah, we'll see if there's any bodies in it. Gosh, you know I like the... Absolutely glorious. Yeah, Dove Crag, Holystone. And look at that. Woohoo! I used to climb up there when I was younger. She lied. Right. I didn't, I can't claim. Nice little spot in here for scare the kids. That's the way back out. Absolutely totes lush. And I was just saying to Lama lady there that I bet I had some parties here back in the day. Cause you know there's like ladies well and all that, and you had your monks and your nuns up this way. Perpetrate as a folk brew. So, oh yeah, that'll be me here. So I was saying that, yeah, and then I just looked down on the floor and guess what I spotted? Yes, a disco ball. How weird's that? how weird's that, eh? Finding a disco ball at Dove Crags. Right, this is me and the disco ball signing off. Waterfalls in. Waterfalls in full flow. I'm going to get under there. Danny, I've got to... You want to charge the camera now?
I'm a camera lady!
Yay! Oh, like something out of a porn shoot.
Here she comes.
Hey! Right. Ciao!
Ciao!
Ciao! Yeah, go on! save myself.
Oh. Oh. I have to watch that later. I'll put your sunglasses on.
Right. So come up from Dove Crag. This is the old Holystone Forest. It's looking a little bit barren.
I can advertise an acid.
But that's pretty chip of you, yeah? Wow.
No parking by the sewer sign, hot dog, my razor broke, water dripping up the spout, but I don't care, let it all hang out. Hanging from a pine tree by my knees, sunshine through the shade, nobody knows what it's all about. It's too much, man, let it all hang out. Saw a man walking upside down, my TV's on the blink. Made Galileo look like a Boy Scout. Sorry about that, let it all hang out.
How nice are Holystone Woods? Look at that.
You come from a contiguous tree.
I come anywhere, me. I come anywhere, me. I'm from a council estate in Newcastle. Bloody, absolutely, totes, stunners. Look at that, that is absolutely blinking lush. Look at that, it's lovely. I'm going close, I'm going in to touch it. A bit of tree porn. Keep me safe. Diversion, as if I would walk under this. What type of idiot do you take us for? Oh man! I've been trying to do a proper video today with getting loads of lush nature shots in. Ruined, you are absolutely ruined, having a smashing day out. So at the bottom end of Holystone now. I've lost Annie, oh, she's up there taking pictures. I'm going to cut down here, I think. Down there. I got to get out down the road. Down by the burn. I've only been that way once years ago with our little Perry. Back under the tree of doom, the tree of certain doom. I'll see how that go. What's the odds of me getting killed under that? Go up and find the llama lady. Got a new backpack. We've both got new handbags today. So I've got my Osprey Atmos. No, I haven't. Annie's got the Atmos. I've got the Osprey Exos. And the llama. Sorry, I will cut that. And the llama lady's out with her new handbag as well. Can you? Right, handbag review.
Hold on.
So that's the. Come on now, talk us through it.
No, it's just a lightweight atom pack.
It's bloody lovely. Where's its little stickers? There. Atom packs at their finest.
Yeah.
Made in England.
Thanks, Tom. Keswick.
Tom of Keswick. Local packs for local people. We'll have no trouble packing.
Oh, local yokels.
Local yokels. So, yes, llama lady's out with her new handbag. I'm out with my new handbag. It's just a glorious day of new handbags.
Drive all night. Right. Brain my numb, can't stop now. For sure ain't no doubt. Keep open mind, let it all hang out. Inside a big brown moon, how does that messy baby up leg? Eating a Reuben sandwich with sauerkraut. Don't stop now, baby, let it out.
Yeah,
well,
drove through Harbottle, yeah, and like looked up and you see all them lovely forests, eh? Where the ones right at the top, the Holystone Forest, the Harbottle Forest. If you climb to the top of here, this is your view. How sweet's that? Eh? Well, I've put some miles in the day. Well, I must have easily done a couple. Been a cracking good day out. Still unsure of where to pitch the accommodation this evening because I'm having a second night out. Rules is all going to be relaxed soon anyway. Either like it or you don't. I'll cut that bit. Yeah. So, how are you, huh?
Hey!
Ah! Hold on, the llama lady's on one. Always on the lookout for a wild camping spot.
It's got a really flat
place there. Yeah? Hold on. We can't get our own film there. The FBI's after her. That's not bad view, is it? I wish I'd brought dinner. Right, we're headed that direction. Coquetdale Trig. I've been up there with a tent already something this year. Before lockdown. Actually, our Drakestone over yonder. So that's Drakestone. That's Harbottle down there. Up there's Kidland Forest and stuff.
Inside a big brown moon, how does that messy baby up leg? Eating a Reuben sandwich with sauerkraut. Don't stop now, baby, let it all hang out. Let it all hang out. Let it all hang out. Let it all hang out.
Morning, campers. What time is it, llama lady?
10:30.
It's a very respectable 10:30 on a Friday morning. This is the camp. This is where obviously we might have camped if we'd been allowed to. As you can see, just a very slender indentation there of possibly a very young fawn as took a gentle 20-minute nap. Llama lady. Fat bitch that she is. Yeah, you can't even see where she's been. She's invisible. Right, your back's on. This is the morning. No bombing as of yet. Quite acceptable, eh? This is me, Scruffy Tramper, day three for the t-shirt. I'll just let you know, for health and hygiene, I've got a full set of clothes and soap back at the car. So I'll be getting a full change. I'm going down commando, squeaking. It's probably too much information, but you do know I like to share things with you. Right, I'm going to get off there, because I like seeing I'm going to get off, and I'll catch you down the trail a little bit. Donovan Senior, reporting from Holystone Forest, accompanied by the marvellous...
Yay!
Miss Ye! Ciao! Anyway, we've left Holystone. We're now in Kidland Forest. Obviously, Annie's on the bespoke guided tour of Northumbria. Loving it. I'll be honest, I'm going to have to put the price up for the scenes that she's seen. I beg your pardon, we'll have no cheek on the bespoke guided tour. I'll get you on camera. So yes, we're in the beautiful Kidland Forest. As you can see, the forest is coming back in lovely after the savage deforestation of it.
It's got trees.
Yeah. And I haven't been here for, well, I don't know, is it? About a year and a half. And it's nice just for to come back and see how the bairns are getting on, you know, how they're managing in life and growing up. I'm going to show Annie a lovely little glade in the woods up there. Because you know we like to scout out areas where tents would love to be pitched.
Yeah, because we're not camping, are we?
No, because obviously we would never camp during lockdown. Oh. I've got work tomorrow. It's Friday today. What's the date, Danny? Do we know?
I don't know.
It's Friday, the end of June, 2020. So we're in the deepest, darkest recesses of Kidland Forest. Annie's getting a whirlwind tour of a lifetime. Hello, my lady is. God knows what I'm going to put on the bill for this one, but I can see it's going to be quite steep. I tell Annie to go ahead because the flies love me, so she gets like a nice fly-free experience. And I'm like pig pen out of Snoopy and Peanuts. How nice is this place? Look at that. Sorry, you had a little woodstock down there, couldn't you? Not that I would. But as a wild camper, all you do is you come out and look for new property that you can, you know, maybe... utilise responsibly for a couple hours overnight. Loving the look of here. And listen. Woo! Nice little bit of echo there coming from up this way. Now the llama lady's gone into the forest. If she gets lost, obviously I've got a clause in the contract for that. She'll not get her deposit back. She actually has gone, she's gotten 2-4. Just tell us what you're seeing, come back. I think she's having a poo. Are you having a poo?
Yeah.
She's not. So I got a crack and I've been outdoors since Wednesday. 4 o'clock on Wednesday. And it's now nearly 4 o'clock on Friday. And if I hadn't got work tomorrow, I would have stayed out tonight. But I've got no uniforms washed. That's the responsibilities of adulthood, is making sure you've got clean uniform for work. So I think it's probably the only time I'm a responsible adult. So we had a lovely... There's Annie's back. Annie, you put your back... There's Annie there. Huh? Yeah, you can't fail to recognise her. Lord love her, she's just great. So yeah, absolutely lush weather as well. I haven't said lush in ages, but I total lush weather. I haven't got any glasses on because of my bushy eyebrows. The greasy marks on the top half of my glasses. That's no good. Right. Little D reporting from Kidland Forest. Wow, it's like a little piece of Narnia, isn't it? Right, that's back safe and sound at the vehicles. It's been a smashing couple of days and he's really enjoyed it. He's enthused, just signed up for a couple more tours. Obviously I've just when I can fit her in. Absolute glorious weather. Doesn't get much finer than that, really, does it? And like I always say, there's that view behind as well. The little Donna signing off. Done one of our bespoke guided tours. No, you're all right, you're fine there, Lord, my lady.
Donna's crappy racky tours.com.
Hey, watch your mind, I'll put you on camera. Wanted by Interpol, this one. I'll catch you on the next one, but for now, it's bye from Little D and the Llama Lady. Woo! Bye! Are you saying bye?
Bye!
Hold on, you're going to say bye? There's Annie! Bye! Bye!
Bless her. Doodles! Stop now, for sure, ain't no doubt. Keep open mind, let it all hang out.